Everyone, I'm here to finally give you my thoughts about the Dark Falcon coming from the Rebuild the Galaxy non-canonical LEGO Star Wars series animated special coming up. This is now finally on the LEGO.com website, so we can see all of the images in full resolution, including any interior details. And you can pre-order it today, although it is $180 US. It's 180 euros, 140 pounds, sorry, 160 pounds UK, or $240 Canadian. Let me, for 1,579 pieces, let me get the bigger versions of the images. We'll also look at the figures. They give you pretty good shots of the figures. First impression from me, it looks much busier than I expected. I normally, when you take something, you just say, I'm going to make it black and with red accents. That's very easy to do, very hard to get wrong. Not that I'm saying that this is wrong, but I thought it was going to be cleaner just from the description and the concept of it. I thought that it would look cleaner. And I think it's just that they have put in a lot more light gray than I expected. I don't know if this is even silver. I think it's mostly just light gray. Unless this is actually dark gray and the renders are just poor here. I think this is light gray. And then I think these ingots might actually be dark gray in there. Because that's dark gray there. That's light gray. And then this is light gray. I think that's dark gray. It might look better in person. We'll look at some photographs as well. Obviously, this is based on the same design as the most recent one. And they've recolored it and changed some of the interior details, given it some exclusive prints for the cockpit there. Most of the other details are done with stickers, which are all new and different for this one. I actually like the use of the red color for the interior, interior almost rafter pieces, framing for the roof sections. All right, we'll take a look at the figures right now. Then this is Beach Luke from left to right. Beach Luke, I'm worried about the torso print for that. Will that, I mean, even in this render, this is a render, and the hue does not match. But I, of course, worry about skin tone on blue ending up looking poor. We'll see. Jedi Vader or White Vader here. Neck down looks really good to me. I'm surprised they actually put arm printing on it as well. On both sides, no less. But the head, with no different coloration for the visor, it just looks, it looks like a prototype to me, or like something that came straight out of a 3D print. You know, it's just raw plastic. It needs some coloration for the eyes. That's too bad. Darth C-3PO here, Darth C-3PO. You wouldn't recognize him because of the black arm in this case. That one looks good. This one's done better than I expected too. With once again, printing for both arms, right on. Darth Dev is a brand new character here, which also looks really good. We'll see what that one's all about. I think it's arguably possibly the best done figure here. Got some gunmetal gray on it. Yeah, it looks really good to me. Darth Jar Jar, unfortunately, does not have any printing for the arms, which is just a little bit of a letdown for a super meme, such as it is. They put more effort into the Darth Dev there. And then over on the right, Dark or Darth Rey looks pretty perfect to me. It's exactly how I did mine too. And it looks right. It looks absolutely right. Okay, photographs. First impression. I was expecting it to look a lot better than the renders, and it doesn't. And I think it's because of the, and I am nitpicking here a little bit. It's going to be a fine toy, but I think it's the light gray color that they use around the cockpit. It makes it look unnecessarily, down resolutioned, for lack of a better term, too toyish. It's black with red accents. Make it the toyest toy ever, but it can still look like hot. It can still look clean and mean, you know? And I think they just missed the mark on that a little bit. The interior, though, lots of space, once again, to operate with your figures around there. Looks like there's some sort of chamber back here with the transparent red. The more transparent colored stuff, the better, as far as I'm concerned. And you got the little throne for Darth Jar Jar. Interesting. Still a sticker, a new sticker. This is going to have a big sticker sheet for the back of the seat over here. The gaming seat for the digital version now of Dedrick. No more physical. Well, no more hollow. Oh, that's the console. It's like a PS5. Wow, I didn't see that before. I wouldn't have expected that. They're strengthening their ties to Sony there, aren't they? Same thing going on as before. Probably this could be a print or could have a sticker in it for the console. I like these stickers here. I like any of this kind of stuff. It's plenty generic, easy to use that one, you know, on other things, on custom things. Stickers up here, you can see that unfortunately the top one isn't going to be as usable as some of the others that they've done in the past. Got your little Death Star laser here, which actually looks pretty good for its size. You know, they didn't size it up or anything. And I think that gap at the front is going to look better on this one. The gap on both of the big pie slices is going to look better on this version because of the color scheme than it did on the previous normal version, where you had the gray and then, you know, the light gray and then the shadow underneath and then the gray here. Black, 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 just a little bit of dark gray through that one little bit of pie slice. I think that part will look cleaner build-wise. And then there's a video, yeah, just the one spinner video, which unfortunately is a render. Those gaps are now in here. That those gaps are looking huge because they're letting all the light come through. That's awkward. You can see the reflection coming through, but that's okay. But yeah, hey, it's Millennium Falcon. Not a whole lot of surprises design wise or build wise I think, but probably a better, more interesting interior. Might be a little bit better toy than the last thing. You can get it right now for $180. Well, you can pre-order it. Comes out on August 1st. If you do plan on buying anything from this wave or from the July 1st wave, please consider using one of my affiliate links. If there is such a thing in the video description, helps me out a ton with my independent content, because yeah, I am going to be buying this at full price because that's the only option there. I'm a regular consumer like you. I will buy this on August 1st from lego.com or wherever it's available. I can get it as quickly as possible. I will build it live on Twitch, and then I will review it over on my LEGO Reviews channel. Thanks for watching for now, and I'll talk to you soon.